1-2, check 1-2, check 1-2. Testing, testing, 1-2, 1-2, check, 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 1-2, check, 1-2, testing, testing, 1-2-3, check, 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 1-2, check, 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 1-2-3, check, 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 1-2-3-4-5.
Got you. You hear me, Zach?
Grab it and hold it.
Then it's talking?
Yep.
Like a walkie-talkie.
Yeah.
Hey, hey. Yeah. I hear you.
Hey, Chuck, can you put your push your call button?
Yep, pushing it. Is everything cool there? from circumstance on our end is going to be when the superintendent, the school board president, and Chris Irvine, the bald guy, are on stage. That's when we were told to start our music.
Okay, sounds good.
All right, sounds good.
All right, thanks.
Football field's a lot longer than a church, huh? Please rise for our national anthem, followed by the pledge.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight? O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free,
song. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America,
and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Great job, Quinn. Please be seated. My first graduation, I forgot to tell everybody that. They stood for my whole speech. Welcome to the graduation ceremony for the class of 2021. Thank you to all the parents, family members, teachers, administrators, support staff, custodial staff, maintenance, food service, transportation, and all our bus drivers that got our kids here, and today is your day. Now I'm going to speak to these guys, all right? First, let me begin by saying I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything you have missed over the last 15 months. I know it's been very difficult, and this is not the way things should have ended. I can't say enough how proud I am to be your principal. You are a remarkable group, and you have made it. After last year's virtual graduation and diploma pickup, we immediately began planning for this school year. Initially, we thought we'd be back in school in the fall. Things would be somewhat normal. As the summer progressed, the guidance and mandates we received frequently changed. During this time, my thoughts constantly were about you, our seniors, and how it would ultimately affect you. After Mr. Benich made about 4 or 5 different schedules, we started the school year with the hybrid schedule and many students working online at home in Cocalico connections. Schools were not built to be half full or for students working remotely. School stadiums and gym bleachers were not built void of students. Auditorium seats were not built to be empty, and cafeterias were not built for kids to eat 6 feet apart. They were built for you to have wonderful memories, experiences, and make connections with your peers and teachers. As the year began, Many experienced feelings of stress and being overwhelmed. There was frustration, struggle, and disconnection. Many of you were disheartened and disappointed with school. But as time passed, you adapted, you adjusted, you coped. You expected and accepted change. You persevered. You led the school and were great role models for our younger students. Without you, we would not have been successful. Lately, I've heard many times that what you went through this year will make you resilient. I disagree. You've always been resilient. Think about it. When you were learning to walk and fell down, you got back up and tried again. When you were learning to ride a bike and fell off, you got back on. When you were learning to drive and had a close call, you got back in the driver's seat. That's how you learn and grow. The challenges you faced this year were very difficult, but you did what you had to do to be successful. Many of you had to wear a mask while playing the sport you love. While this was tough to do, our teams still had great success. Your prom had to be canceled, but you were creative and planned a senior gala. Some had to sing while wearing masks and play instruments 6 feet apart with coverings, and you still had two wonderful concerts. Some of you had to be quarantined and had to keep up with your work remotely. You joined Google Meets with your friends and classmates to keep up with your labs and class and your schoolwork. Just like you did when you took your first steps or rode your bike by yourself for the first time, you used your drive and resiliency within you to be successful. You are so much more than a group of kids that went through a pandemic together. You're a group of students who got through a very challenging time together without complaint, and you thought outside the box to make the best of it. In an era of uncertainty and unimaginable events, you are the group that'll lead the way. You are strong, kind, and determined. The cohesiveness, camaraderie, and kindness you have demonstrated will be long remembered. You're a tight-knit group. You've touched the hearts of so many. You truly made a difference, and you'll continue to do so. That's what life is about, making a difference. That's at the core of who you are. Each of you will take a different path, but you also take a little piece of Cocalico with you. After the ceremony, seniors, celebrate with your family. Take time tonight to thank your parents. They've done a remarkable job, and this has been very difficult for them also. Wherever your future leads you, we'll be watching and cheering for you. I'm looking forward to updates about your lives and seeing where your path leads you. Before you go, I want to make sure I say thank you for all that you taught me. The class of 2021 will be greatly missed. If you were the last class I spoke to, I'd be okay with that because you were the best. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to recognize the top 10 students of the class. When I call your name, please rise. Connor Meese, Alana Tronosky, Olivia Sensenig, Alex Mellinger, Jenna Crick, Aaliyah Yang, Caitlin Rank, Daniel Klump, Joshua Garman, and Isabel Mack. Nice job. A round of applause. All right, grab a seat. It's my honor to introduce Quinn Rosato, your class president.
I would just like to say hi to everyone here. Thank you for coming. And I'd also, again, like to thank all the staff and everyone who made this possible for us to be able to do this today. The title of my speech is Untitled. And I won't lie, at first it was slightly because I had no idea what I wanted to say to everyone today. And then I thought about other titles and tried to come up with something else. And I decided to stick with it because I remember in art class, I was once told that if you make something that you wanted the viewer to interpret completely on their own, without any prior thoughts put into their mind, then you could leave a piece untitled. So I hope that as I speak, you take what I say however you'd like in whatever way you see fit. Let's say you need to fill out an application, which I know a lot of you have been doing as we're all heading off to colleges or jobs or going off on other paths. But what do you put on that application? You put your name, your age, your school probably. Maybe that you play sports or that you're in the band or that you strive in your art or science classes. You would give a list of descriptions that pile together to form the ultimate version of yourself. But what if someone sat you down and said, "No, who are you really?" What would you say? Could you only list the things you wrote on that application? Would you still say all the things that pile together to show the most perfect version of yourself? I hope you'd have another list. The way it feels to hold someone's hand, driving in the car listening to Dermot Kennedy and Kalani, the smell of Christmas trees, butterflies, being the youngest of three girls, always being late to everything, iced caramel coffee with almond milk and sugar, making someone you love smile or laugh. That's my list, or some of it at least. That's my list for now, and every day that list gets bigger. My list is filled with every moment, every time anyone has shown me love, any time I've felt joy, every person I've ever crossed paths with, and all of my favorite things. Even the not so good parts of my life, my flaws and the things I can't change. I'm a terrible swimmer, I'm never on time, I'm extremely emotional. But all of these things are on my list, because they're all me. Every single moment in your life will have shaped you in some way, no matter how small. And I encourage you to let them. Embrace it. To everyone graduating here today, from here on out, things are up to you. Your life is completely up to you. Not only when you look at yourself, but when you look at others, ignore the stigmas. Ignore the societal norms. Ignore what everyone is saying about what's cool and what's not. Ignore the constructs we put around ourselves. Because in the end, none of it matters. Beneath that perfect application of ourselves, we're all just lists. You are a collection of the kind words spoken to you, the roads you've driven on, the people you've passed, and the things you've smelled, the way that someone has looked at you. Neil deGrasse Tyson said, "We are stardust brought to life, then empowered by the universe to figure itself out, and we have only just begun." You are allowed to be untitled. It's okay to let things that have molded you speak for themselves. You don't owe the world anything more than what you want to give it. You are not a label, you're a work of art, and it's okay to not have a title. Thank you. It is now my honor to introduce Connor Meese.
Hello, my name is Connor Meese. I'm valedictorian here at Cocalico High School. And first of all, I would like to thank my family. I would like to thank my mom for being the first real mom I've had and someone who loves me. And I would like to thank my dad for trying his best every day to support our large family of 10 people. I'd like to thank every single teacher that I've had here at Cocalico, especially the math teachers for teaching me math. I want to thank Ms. Shirey for helping me find opportunities to take more advanced classes. I also want to thank my piano tutor, Mr. Arment, for teaching me piano. Lastly, I want to thank my friends for being cool. So the title of my speech is How to Live a Fearless Life. And I want to share a personal experience of how I did something that was outside my comfort zone at the time that helped me grow as a person. In 10th grade, with extremely little musical experience, I became a member of the marching band here at Cocalico. Now this was a decision that I was pretty unsure about when I was making it. It didn't really make a ton of sense for me to join the marching band. I didn't have a background in musical ability or skill. I had never really done any extracurricular activity, and I was comfortable with where I was in my own life just pursuing academic success. Even so, I signed up for marching band during my 10th grade year to play the marimba. At the time, I had no idea what a marimba was, just that it was similar to a keyboard. During my time in the marching band, I had a lot of fun making new friends, experiencing things I had never experienced before, and forming memories that I'll be able to keep with me throughout my life. Something that I realized from that decision is that we don't have to fear what is going to result from taking new opportunities. Pushing myself into that uncomfortable area where I had no musical talent was a difficult decision. I did have the fear of what could happen, and what if I just wasn't good enough to be a part of the marching band? It would make sense. Everybody else probably has a lot more musical experience than I do. And what if nobody wanted me to be in their social circle within the marching band? That would also make sense. The people there would probably have known each other for a while and already formed strong bonds between themselves. But if I would have acted on those fears and the things that seemed logical, I probably wouldn't have joined the marching band and would not have had that positive experience. And now that I took that opportunity back in 10th grade, I have memories and bonds with me that I can keep forever, and that's something really special. So the main thing that I want you to apply to your life is that you should be trying to go out of your comfort zone and explore new opportunities by beating back the fear of what could happen when you take those opportunities. I think a large reason why people don't do things sometimes is because they don't feel good enough to be part of some activity or new experience because there are already people that are far better than them at it. I encourage everyone to not give in to that kind of fear. I don't think people really recognize that thought as fear sometimes. I think the idea of not taking opportunities because you don't think you'll be able to be as good as other people is definitely a kind of fear that we have inside ourselves. It comes from a natural desire to be the best, and when we see everyone doing better than us, we definitely shy away from wanting to do whatever that thing is. So don't compare yourselves to others. If there's some opportunity out there that you want to take or some dream that you want to follow, go out there and do it. Don't let the fear hold you back and live a fearless life. Thank you. It is my honor to introduce Joy Gonzalez and Olivia Sensnick.
Hi, I'm Joy Gonzalez.
And I'm Olivia Sensenig.
And we wanted to say thank you for letting us speak at graduation today. Okay, who could have imagined how much our lives could change over the past year? Who would have known how much harder it would be to give our best effort this school year? Did we reach all the goals we strive for? Did we give our best, and will we continue to give our best?
Life is unpredictable, and it is constantly changing. Anything you think you may know to be true one day can be flipped upside down the next. We cannot predict exactly what will happen in the coming weeks, months, or years.
This has been especially evident over the past year, but it can be seen all throughout life. When life brings hard things, including new goals to reach, it can reveal some of the best opportunities to grow and improve yourself as well as the world around you.
This reminds me of a parable whose author is unknown. It's a story about adversity. There are three pots filled with water, and they are brought to a boil. Each pot of water contains something different. One has a carrot, the second contains an egg, and then the third is a coffee bean. The carrot goes in tough and comes out softened. The egg starts out soft and becomes hardened, and the coffee bean emerges the same as before, though it has changed the water around it into something better. It has made coffee. The boiling water symbolizes adversity and challenges.
I'm sure we've all felt that over the past few years in school, and we will face it more in life. When you're placed under pressure or in a situation that's going to change, how will you respond to it? Like a coffee bean, we need to let these experiences shape us into a better person while improving both ourselves as well as the environment around us. This example teaches us that change is not always negative. In fact, it can bring out the best in us. While it can be scary to have so many things out of our control, sometimes change is the best. We can give our best and change our world and others, spurring them to give their best too.
A challenge that I faced in my life was switching schools. I came to Cocalico in 7th grade, and that felt like my boiling pot, my new environment. The strong relationships I had built at my previous school were completely gone, and I was surrounded by people who were, at that time, complete strangers. At times, it was hard not to focus on the negative aspects. However, I didn't want to become hardened or bitter like the egg, or be weakened like the carrot. I was able to accept the change in my life and begin to start over with new friendships and grow not only as a person, but also in how I can connect and relate to people. So while this change was hard at first, I now can look back and clearly see that it was what was best. For me, God was a big part of this. I know He is faithful to go before me and with me in all of the challenges and hardships that I face. It was a blessing to see how God used people at Cocalico that used to be strangers to become some of my closest friends. I'm so thankful for all the experiences and relationships that have been built here at Cocalico that have shaped me into the person that I am today.
Just like in her story, change will come. It's not a matter of if, but when. How will you approach it? The most difficult part of change is knowing how to accept it and use it to better yourself, despite the feelings of the unknown. But with so much that is indeed unknown, how do you know what is best? When nothing is guaranteed, how can you be sure that you are doing the right thing? Who knows where you could be in 50 years? Who knows where you could be tomorrow?
What kind of person will you be?
What kind of person do you want to be? Okay, this might sound like we're getting pretty serious, so let's not forget what the coffee bean did. It made coffee. That's a student's best friend. Don't forget the experiences that bring you joy among the hard things, and our friends and family are always encouraging us to make coffee and do our best. High school was full of encouragement, as well as experiences and memories such as
sitting in the auditorium as a freshman and doubting that Mr. Irvine would be right when he said the next 4 years would fly by.
Mr. Irvine telling us to giddy up when we're already late.
Nights staying up past 2 a.m. studying for classes, such as anatomy.
Friends commenting on our bad parking jobs in the school parking lot.
We will obviously miss our favorite classes, greatest teachers, and best memories. Both moving forward comes excitement for what our future will be, what we will do, all the people we will meet, and who we will become. Your attitude and work ethic are your best and sometimes only defenses against life's uncertainty and changes.
To live your best life, you need to be your best self. So work hard and have a good attitude. Let your known work ethic and attitude be overwhelming to the uncertainty of life. Let it reflect the type of future you want to have. Don't regret not working towards your goals.
As seniors, we are proud of all of our accomplishments within Cocalico. In the past years, we have seen the hard work and dedication that everyone has put into academics, athletics, extracurriculars, and all of your projects and actions. We look forward to seeing what other accomplishments we will all achieve in the near future. But success will not come without challenges. You are going to face that boiling pot. So remember that, like the coffee bean, you can let hard things affect you but not tear you down, and you can change your perspective of the hard things while influencing others to be their best as well.
Though we hate to say goodbye, we look forward to what life has to offer. We must continue these good habits even as we leave the doors of Cocalico and into our futures. And now that the rest of your lives are here, we only have one thing to say. Giddy up! It's our honor to introduce Cutler Snyder.
I'd like to offer my time to you today to reflect on some unique ideas I discovered while attending Cocalico and further elaborate on some of the lessons and themes that I derived from my experiences. As many of us have come to learn, our environments play a crucial part in tuning our character. Amongst peers and mentors exists a mutual path of influence, which opens us up to new ideas and opinions. We use these tools to help us progress in life and carve lanes for our futures moving forward. On top of social gains that high school has to offer, there's also the task of exploring one's interests through core classes and electives. Personally, my passion for certain subjects seemed to evolve over a portion of time, growing stronger and weaker as I got older. It dawned on me, as I'm sure it has for many of my peers, that we have to sooner or later meet the milestone of monetizing on the things we became good at throughout high school, or at least pursue something based on a skill we discovered during the time being. Whether that be a distressing or pleasant task for you lies on your shoulders. However, something I learned to keep in mind is the idea of being a jack of all trades, but master of none. If what you hear holds true in regards to something requiring 10,000 hours to master, think about where you may be, percentage-wise, with your own crafts. Like others, I find it important to indulge in new hobbies and explore things foreign to us, but their life strengthened acknowledging that our most precious resources at play when doing so, that being time. To put it in practical terms, imagine a scenario where an architect spent the bulk of their early adulthood becoming okay at bowling, okay at cooking, okay at welding, and okay at architecture. Now, I don't think anybody would really like the idea of their architect being mediocre at their job, even if the architect is also a mediocre cook. Rather, it'd be more practical to get a highly skilled architect who'd make for an awful chef. On that note, I'd advise you to let the awful chef build your house. Being the best mechanic, graphic designer, neurosurgeon, teacher, car salesperson, taxidermist, stockbroker, janitor, director, shipping supervisor, whatever may have you, may not be in your field of reach currently, for progression is not linear, and goals are meant to be ongoing. However, before you can be that thing, you have to be yourself first. Now that is the best thing you can be. That is the best thing, excuse me. Now that is one thing that you can be the best at being prior to any career endeavor. After all the knowledge or nonsense you've been willing to listen to me spew at you, I'd like to conclude this commencement with this. A close friend of mine once explained to me how he thought every great idea and or invention has always been in existence / floating around prior to its discovery. Only with the right time and right people, said idea or invention will eventually come to fruition. This concept made me think about growing up in a lot of ways. You have an inclination as to the person you might be like in the future based on your given interests, peer groups, families, etc. Then lo and behold, a good chunk of years pass and that passion, past envision of self is entirely different to the one you've become. Hopefully to your benefit, you too are that good idea that just needed the right amount of time and right people to prosper. Thank you.
They were awesome. Nice job. Give them a round of applause. It is my honor to declare that these students have met the requirements needed to graduate from Cocalico High School. Dr. Musser, Reverend Eshelman, I recommend these students for diplomas without reservation. Each student has attained the knowledge, skills, and character that will make our community proud. Reverend Eshelman, it is my honor to present to you the members of Cocalico High School Class of 2021.
Class of 2021, there's going to be a lot of applause here tonight for you. I'm just going to ask you just for a moment if you would actually get to your feet and to applaud Mr. Irvine, your principal, as well as the entire high school staff that has helped you every step along the way. What do you say about that? Thank you. You can take your seats. I realize that many of you as a graduating class may not know me, maybe even most of you that might be the case. My name is Kevin Eshelman and I serve as president of the Cocalico School District Board of Directors. And so when I speak to you this evening, I speak not only on my own behalf, but I speak on behalf of the other 8 school board members as well. And we are in elected office in our community, and so there's a sense in which that I can maybe presume to speak a little bit for the 20,000 plus residents of our community. When I say to you as the graduating class of 2021, congratulations, you are an exceptional class of graduates. We are exceedingly proud of you, and we are absolutely confident that you are fully prepared for this day and for everything that life holds in front of you. And we are also confident that no matter where life takes you, you're going to represent Cocalico, both the school district and the community very, very well. You know, education takes various forms. Of course, when we think about education, we oftentimes go towards the academics, the classroom, the paper, the books. But you also need to think about your extracurricular activities, the athletics. You need to think about arts and drama, music. Then you think about the things that you've learned outside of the school setting, maybe in your volunteer work, perhaps in your work experience. And then there are those things that educate us that we don't necessarily sign up for. We really don't, these are things that happen to us circumstantially that teach us, even though it's not necessarily what we want or how we want to learn. So I think of what you've learned in the past year, beyond the past year, and I think specifically of the Eagle Pact, P-A-C-T. So the P stands for problem solving. Oh my goodness, you guys have excelled in problem solving. The A stands for adaptability. You wrote the book on adaptability. The C stands for communication, yes, in all of its forms. And the T stands for teamwork, which was actually part of your survival in this past year and your success. You've learned through circumstance, and it's been your resilience, your commitment, and your concern for one another that has really equipped you for this day and has equipped you beyond this day, and perhaps in a way that no other graduating class has quite been equipped for. Now, I know that you thought all your testing is done, at least for a little bit, but I want to give you a little bit of a quiz. I wonder if anybody could name the 10 most rich people in the world. Maybe a few of them, a couple of them perhaps. I wonder if you could name Nobel Prize winners, maybe 8 of them, or 7 Academy Award winners. And while we honor and respect all of them, and we recognize that renown and that kind of influence is very, very good, I would also then go to the other side of that quiz. How many of you can think of 3 people that you like to spend time with? How many can think of like 5 people that encourage you along the way, or 4 or 5 close friends that helps you through a difficult time, teachers that encourage you along your academic career? See, we oftentimes think about renown and places of significance as the place that makes the biggest difference. And we honor and respect all of those positions, but sometimes the places with the greatest impact is those things that are up close. It's the personal part of that. And I know that you've been well equipped, and I know that as you think about this day, oftentimes you graduate with a thought of, what am I going to do to make a living? And I want you to know that as graduating seniors of the class of 2021, you've actually been equipped to do more than make a living. Circumstantially, you've been equipped to make a difference. And we know that you will represent Cocalico well no matter where you go. And we say congratulations to you, and may God bless you wherever you go.
Christian V. Boyroy. Madeline Joy Hanna.
Olivia K. Sensen.
Caden Holmes. Zachary James Hooper.
Cutler Emerson Snyder.
Juliana L. Martin.
Alexis Whitney Adams.
Taylor Ann Rathman.
Julian B.
Luke Joseph Verdi. Robert Matthew Adams. Nathan Stephen Benton.
Jerica Nicole Boyer.
Mira R. Bhavani. Natasha Lynn Bowman.
Nicholas Alexander Bird.
Damian M. Branch.
Mackenzie Claire Bird.
Brooklyn Lee Bryan.
Lydia R. Burton.
Alyssa Nicole Brubaker.
Michael Timothy Butts.
Holly Nicole Bird.
Philip Patrick Bird.
Brady W. Burke.
Zacchaeus William Carrasco.
Kylie Brooke Burkholder.
Tristan James Current.
Aspen Paige Butler.
Michael Jack Davis.
Lily Ann Bazard.
Gerald Andrew DeBalco III.
Margaret P. Carpenter.
Michaela Susan DeVault.
Anthony John Serrato.
Ruthleen Adassa Dominique.
Hannah M. Custer.
Emily Ann Dunn.
Josiah Nasir Davis Millisock.
Alex Ryan Estrada.
Donovan Arnez De Jesus.
Elijah Firestone.
Leanne Michelle Digman.
What's your first name?
Luella Formica.
Danielle Adora Drain.
Kendall Lee Funk.
Caitlin Barbara Arisman.
Joshua C. Garman.
Asia N. Fabiani.
Dean M. Gaiman.
Logan Michael Flatt.
Tyler Scott Gaiman.
Nathan Fryer.
Maria Joanne Gortman.
Kaylee Ann Gantowski.
Jack J. Greenwood.
Logan Christopher Garrett.
Noah James Griffin.
Robert Allen Gaiman.
Morgan E. Groff.
Toby O'Neill Velez Good.
Kyle William Hankins.
Tyler J. Goshert.
Jennifer Rose Hartman.
Emily Nicole Greist.
Jonathan Robert Hartz.
Kaylee M. Grimwood.
Madison Nicole Heilman.
Evan R. Haldeman.
Hayden Hirsch.
Jacob Zoltan Hankins.
Ellie Joy Hollinger.
Logan James Harting.
Liberty Paige Jacoby.
Elizabeth Christine Hartrapt.
Justin Travis Jones.
Angelina D. Heft.
Dalton Bradley Keeney.
Keon I. Hang.
Kyla Kemper.
Logan R. Hilton.
Adriana Kapokas.
Caitlin Hosler.
Sarah E. Kinney.
Connor Johnston.
Aaliyah Madison Cole.
Carter Lewis Keith.
Jenna M. Crick.
Madison M. Kemper.
Ashton Lagos.
Haley Alyssa Kiefer.
Connor Michael Leach.
Ariana L. Killian.
Cheyenne M. Letterhouse.
Daniel Stephen Klump.
Isabel Mack.
Angelina Kotlarova.
Margaret Grace Maria Marks.
Mackenzie Kalaga.
Braden Scott Martin.
Gage Joseph Lawhorn.
Hunter Martin.
Miguel A. Lice.
Kaya Elizabeth Martin.
Mallory Mabel Latterell.
Adrian Lynn McGallagher.
Darren Michael Main.
Alex Michael Mellinger.
Elena M. Martin.
Juan C. Mercedes Jr.
Shelby Lynn Martin.
Lauren Ann Metzger.
Madeline Elizabeth Matos.
David Matthew Mitchell.
Blake Avery McGowan.
Gabriel Christopher Darius Moore.
Dominic Paul Manichella.
Abby Michelle Motter.
Colby J. Mertz.
Sage A. Musser.
Alexis Levine Miller.
Carson S. Nash.
Jonathan A. Moldovano.
Craig Douglas Neal.
Madison Paige Moore.
Dakota L. Nichols.
Emila Jivua Mua.
Tristan D. Nolt.
Courtney Brianne Meyer.
Cole Dehaven Norris.
Sophia M. Naylor.
Nunneville.
Carter Allen Nunneville.
Kirsten Abigail Newman.
Andrew T. Oaken.
Megan Renee Nolt.
Absent Victoria Phillips.
Brock N. Norman.
Anastasia Rosemarie Plotnikoff.
Caleb M. Knoll.
Felicia Lee Prisdale.
Ashton Michelle Oaks.
Caitlin G. Rank.
Melody G. Pa.
Jane G. Register.
Seth B. Pittsburgh.
Adam Joseph Rhodes.
Kyra Nicole Powers.
Caitlin R. Rivera.
Nathan Quirk.
Juan Antonio E. Saavedra, Jr.
Jacob Rebristi.
Nalea J. Souter.
Nicholas A. Reich.
Yulia O. Shapiro.
Nicholas Edward Rutkowski.
Dalton Gregory Smith.
Brooke M. Souter.
Ty T.J. Sray.
Brenton Edward Sensenig.
Autumn R. Steiner.
Matthew Ryan Slovak.
Alana Ruth Sterner.
Kalijah T. Smith.
Riley B. Stoltz.
Faith Amber Steffi.
Christopher Lee Stuck.
Alice Stephanie.
Gianna M. Titus.
Victoria Jane Steiff.
Carlos Armando Torres.
Cade Dylan Stoltzfus.
Elena Marie Trinosky.
Aiden Michael Sturdivant.
Jacinda S. Varner.
Benjamin William Toomey.
Rohan Walia.
Lindsay Elizabeth Troutman.
Jacob Ryan Walsh.
Micah Daniel Ulysses.
Madison G. Weaver.
Bryn Catherine Moschel.
Aaron James Weitzel.
Edward Joseph Walker.
Aiden Michael Wentz.
Braden Clark Weaver.
Jared Grant White.
Miranda Lynn Weaver.
Austin James Weeder.
Sierra N. Wenrick.
Anthony T. Zhang.
Jaden Nicole Wentz.
Brandon Yu Peng Yang.
Laura Elizabeth Whitaker.
Scott A. Youngberg.
Haley Jasmine Wittenberg.
Josiah James Zimmerman.
Aaliyah P. Yang. Glenda K. Yeager. Timothy Alex Yudenko. Cassie Marie Zunner.
By the power bestowed on me as superintendent of the Cocalico School District, I now declare you graduates of Cocalico High School, class of 2021. Congratulations, you made it. You've worked hard and you deserve to be celebrated today. Family, friends, faculty, members of the Cocalico School Board, let's give the class of 2021 another round of applause. Now to the graduates, I ask you to look around. What a blessing that we can celebrate your accomplishments today in the presence of your family, your classmates, your teachers, and all those who've supported you during a very challenging year. Let's give those supporters the round of applause they also deserve. And I think for tonight, if you would have seen the team that came out to clean off the bleachers, the chairs, that was quite a team working feverishly. So all the buildings and grounds, administrators, teachers, everyone who just came out to help, give them a round of applause. It was quite a team effort to support you tonight. And speaking of support, I have a story to share. The version I read was described by Franklin Shargel. You may have heard it already, but I thought it was fitting for today. It's called Who Packed Your Parachute? And it's about Charles Plum, who was a U.S. Navy jet pilot in Vietnam. After 75 combat missions, his plane was destroyed by a surface-to-air missile. Plum ejected and parachuted into enemy hands. He was captured and spent 6 years in a communist Vietnamese prison. He survived the ordeal and now lectures on lessons learned from that experience. One day when Plum and his wife were sitting in a restaurant, a man at another table came up to him and said, "You're Plum. You flew jet fighters in Vietnam from the aircraft carrier Kitty Hawk. You were shot down." "How in the world did you know that?" asked Plum. "I packed your parachute," the man replied. Plum gasped in surprise and gratitude. The man pumped his hand and said, "I guess it worked." Plum assured him, "It sure did. If your chute hadn't worked, I wouldn't be here today." Plum couldn't sleep that night thinking about that man. He says, "I kept wondering what he looked like in a Navy uniform, a white hat, a bib in the back, bell-bottom trousers. I wonder how many times I may have seen him and not even said good morning or how are you or anything, because you see, I was a fighter pilot and he was just a sailor." He thought of the many hours the sailor had spent at a long wooden table in the bowels of the ship, carefully weaving the shrouds and folding the silks of each chute, holding in his hand each time the fate of someone he did not know. Now, when he lectures, Plum asks his audience, "Who's packing your parachute?" Everyone has someone who provides what they need to make it through the day. Plum also points out that he needed many kinds of parachutes when his plane was shot down over enemy territory. He needed his physical parachute, his mental parachute, his emotional parachute, and his spiritual parachute. He called on all these supports before reaching safety. Class of 2021, this year, you may have needed help packing your parachute. The challenges were too great to go it alone. Changing schedules, online classes, quarantines. It certainly wasn't the senior year you were anticipating, and the uncertainty of it all posed its own challenges. When you were down and overwhelmed, I hope you reached out to someone for help to make it through, or even better, I hope someone reached out to you and offered you their help. Perhaps a friend, a parent, a classmate, a neighbor, maybe it was a pastor or the boss for whom you work part-time. Whoever provided that help to you, be sure to thank them. And as you go from here, may you remember that there are many people willing and waiting to help pack your parachute. Whether your next steps include college or the military or trade school or a full-time job, look around for the parachute packers. Reach out to them for assistance and be sure to express gratitude and appreciation to them. And then offer to be a parachute packer for others who would need your help too. Graduates, a world in which we accept help, express our gratitude, and then give back to those around us is a world in which we can safely arrive at our destinations. And maybe even like tonight, it might come with a double rainbow. May you trust those who pack your parachute so you can jump with both feet into the adventure. May your journey be filled with glorious opportunity, and may each new endeavor result in a safe and secure landing that keeps you from harm's way and gives you great success. Class of 2021, congratulations again. Best wishes for a fulfilling future. Thank you. And now it is my honor to introduce Quinn Rosado for the final celebration.
Now that we are graduates, it is time to turn our tassels. And now it's time for the cap toss. Parents, get your cameras ready, and students, please remove the tassel on your cap. And on the count of three, we'll toss our caps. Oh, everybody stand up. All right, everybody ready? Parents ready? Cameras ready? One, two, three! I know, one more thing. Thank you. I say this after, like, give it a minute and then say this part. I just give it a minute. After everyone retrieves their cap, now can we have everyone rise for our alma mater? The words are in your programs. Thank you.
To